Good morning. I feel like I'm so Desperate Housewives whenever I stay at the apartment because I use a regular coffee pot. Like, how long has it been since you've used a regular coffee pot? That's like my favorite show that was ever on TV, and they always used one. So I always think of the girls of Wisteria Lane whenever I use my traditional coffee pot here. But the coffee that I've been using is this McCafe medium roast, and it really is good. That makes quite a good cup of coffee. Oh, those dishes sat overnight. Sorry. We keep everything here that I keep at the house, so I don't have to pack like everything that, you know, I need. It's kind of hard to keep two houses going. But don't need no hateration, holleration in this dance for me. Let's get percolating while you're waiting. So just dance for me. Y'all know that song? Come on, let's get it percolating. I'm ready for some coffee this morning, honey. David went and got me some coffee creamer last night. Where are you at? Here he is. And it is French vanilla. That's fine. We can go with that, right? Give me a big mug here this morning. Well, yeah, I'll go with this one. We're almost there. Morning is not morning until you've had your coffee, right? I'll show you some pictures on our little fridge of air. It is Gunner, my nephew, Santa, several years ago in his Star Wars hoodie. There's my niece in her basketball picture this year. She's wearing Wet n Wild hot pink lipstick. I seen it on the counter, so I know what she's wearing. This was our last time at Parrot Mountain. We go like all the time and hold the parrots, and he hung up his birthday cards from my mom and stepdad and my niece and nephew. So sweet. Oh yes, honey. And so on Desperate Housewives, I was always so impressed by the height they would get when pouring the coffee. Like, they didn't hold it down here, right? They'd go like, you could hear that drizzle. Look. I'm so Susan Meyer right now. I'm excited to try this French vanilla creamer. I still need to remember to bring like nails and screws, okay? Because I can't hang anything, but I'm going to hang this right here above the sink. Get kisses from the missus when you do the dishes. He does do the dishes here a lot on the days I'm not here. It's pretty good. I mean, it's no marshmallow hot cocoa, but come on. It's pretty good. Like, it definitely hits the spot for now. All right.
Geez, so I just spent the last hour and 52 minutes on the phone. I spent an hour and I think 20 waiting. I was on hold that long to renew my health coverage for 2017. We have to do it every year because I buy mine privately where I'm not employed outside the home. So that took forever. And then we had to go through all the different plans that they had available. And my health insurance, I had a really low deductible for 2016, but my monthly premium was $425, I think is what we pay monthly for my insurance. So, and I never go to the doctor. I never went one time in 2016. So I bumped the deductible up, which brought my monthly premium down. And so now this year for 2017, it'll only be $225 a month. But I do go to the dentist quite regularly. So my Delta Dental plan, I kept the same one because it's like super good coverage, and it's $24 a month. So altogether last year we were paying right at $450 because the Delta Dental and the Anthem together. This year it's only going to be $250. So a little bit better. But I do have to find like an endocrinologist here to get my Hashimoto's under control, and yuck. But anyways, while I was on hold, I did manage to clean everything up a little.
So I got everything clean. Okay, guys, I have a question. Ever since we moved in, our burners had this. I've used everything I know of to try to clean this. Look how terrible it looks. Did the previous tenants, like, do something to our burners? How do I get this off? Do any of you have a flat top stove, you know, that has this on it? Like, it don't come off. I don't know what it is. Anywho, let a girl know if you know any solutions. You hear my baby walking? There it is. It hates the camera. I'm not going to put it through that. But I got Mount Rushmore of laundry put away. I've still got these t-shirts. I have washed all of the scatter rugs. The ones for the bathroom are in the dryer as we speak. I cleaned the toilet. I cleaned the vanity. So I'm just trying to get some stuff done. I even wiped down our washer and dryer. So got everything done. Got our hamper emptied. So yeah. I need to look. This is before we have Piper. But I'm going to go ahead and get ready. I took my shower last night, so I just have to like fix my hair, wash my face, brush my teeth, and get dressed and put on some makeup. And I'm going to go on over to my mom's. It's been so delicious. It's pumpkin praline waffles, candleberry. Most people get hot maple toddy in candleberry, but I used to buy it. I don't burn it anymore. There was a girl that I know on Facebook. She's from my hometown, but we were never close. Like, she didn't like hang out with me in high school or anything like that, but I've always known her, you know? And she was just so sweet, always on my Facebook, always on my blog, and commented on everything I did. And the last thing she posted, I had posted a picture of a hot maple toddy candle. And that was the last thing she commented on my page. And she was like, "That's my favorite candle. I burn it all the time." And like the next day, she shot and killed herself. And it just leaves a weird feeling about that candle with me. I don't know. I don't burn it anymore. But I thought I would show. I don't mean to be a Debbie Downer, but that's really what happened. I'm going to show you all how I kind of do my makeup when I'm here. That's really one of the only things that that I pack to bring here.
All right. I do believe I am what you call ready. I'm going to start another load of laundry. And I'm ready to leave, right? Yeah. Okay.
But filling up, it's bitterly cold out. I didn't even look to see what the temperature was, but I'm back inside letting the car fill up while I'm in the warmth, right?
No, thank you. Thank you.
Got me some cheesy tots and some chicken fries, honey. We have a Burger King there towards the house, but I ain't even been yet. But I always stop at this one whenever I'm passing through. But I'm hungry. It's 2:34, and look at the degrees outside, honey. 27 degrees.
It's 10 days to Christmas. I just now seen that 15th.
I ain't even nowhere near finished Christmas shopping.
I can have another you in a minute. Matter of fact, he'll be here in a minute. I can pack all your bags within a string. Cause you made your bed to lay in it. What I envision.
This is what happens when you live in the mountains. Your signal is always coming and going in XM radio. Mountain life, right? I'm going to show you both a positive and a negative thing through here. Tonight when I come home, if this is all lit up, I'll show it. But this house right here, they always have like a ton of decorations. You can't really tell in the daytime, but I'll show it tonight. But right here at this little church, this is where my grandfather was in a car wreck and was killed right here. As he came around this curve, he was in the oncoming lane over here on the four lane, and someone crossed. They were on drugs and they crossed over all four lanes, and as soon as he came around the corner, they hit him head on and killed him. So, and the people that lived in that house before these people, they knew him. And the guy came out because he worked in coal. And my grandfather was on his way to work in the coal mines. And he didn't know him. He was pinned under his truck. And he was alive. He lived until they sedated him for surgery. He was flown to UK hospital that's in Lexington, and actually what killed him was his aorta ruptured. His, you know, your aorta is your largest artery in your body, and Granny's aorta is what killed her, her aortic aneurysm. So ironic that both of them, I think my battery died in the middle of saying that, but I think it's ironic that they both died as a result of a problem with their aorta, you know? I promise this video is not going to be a down video. We're going to be happy today, right? I figured I would show you what our mountains look like. A lot of people like to see the mountains. Slam dunk, get stick, get flippin' and ride that B-double-O-T-Y, oh my. Ooh, that's it. Come on, come on. Whoop, there it is, I'm done. Right, guys, I'm going to turn this down, and I figured I'd show you all a little bit of the drive. Our mountains are spectacular when they're in bloom. We have like basically no flatland here. We're all mountains in this part of the state. It's funny, in the southeast part of the state, it's like a different state almost completely than the northern part where I live now. But we are mountain folk back here at home. Literal hillbillies. But in the spring and summer, I'll try to come back and shoot some footage and let you all see all the green trees and stuff when they're in bloom. But yeah, hit it on to mom. I thought I would bring you here and show you my little granny's last house that she lived in. God bless my granny. It's the house with all the peaks. It's like a little church, and there's her sign. It's still up. Christ is risen. My poor little granny. Granny had remarried, and her husband is 90 years old. And he was trying to live on his own after she passed, and he fell and broke his hip. So his children came and got him and took him to their home about an hour from here, and the house sold. So. And I know this isn't her, but it's, you know, and it truly is just, you know, bricks and boards, and but it was her last earthly home. And she actually tripped over this railing one time and fell, and it broke her neck, and she didn't even know it. Granny was tough as nails, Lord. But, yeah. It's like taking a bullet, seeing her home. In a better home now, though, right? So I thought I would show you my grade school. This is where my niece and nephew go now, too. We are the Bulldogs. Once a Bulldog, always a Bulldog, honey. But after that, I was a Yellow Jacket. But deep down, I'm still a Bulldog, honey. And I'll tell you something funny. This house right here, that was the house of my first love. Way before the days of David. So, Lord, the stories I could tell you about that house. I'll keep it to myself.
So, hi, DS.
What kind of little bitty camera is that?
Canon.
Cute.
Mom's showing me her new cell phone.
This is Disney. He's a Sean. He just had his hair did today, didn't you?
He's a pretty baby.
He's a good boy.
Let's see your phone. So, guys, this is my house. My old house. But,
I can't show my table where my ribbon is, but come and look at my tree.
Okay, I'll show them your tree. I'm going to show them this one. I got Mom this one. Mom, what did I get you this tree for? Your birthday? What did I get you this tree for? Your birthday?
Christmas.
Christmas one year, I guess. But it is a really cute little tree. And she has the same gingerbread people. This is me and Mom and my brother when we were little. Family picture. But this is what their TV normally stays on, the security system. But yeah, there's my baby boy. It's Goldie's. But this is like the family room. This is Bootsy, the big kitty right here. He's so, hi, Boots. Hi, Bootsy. The kitchen, the garage is out here. You already getting Christmas cards, Mom?
Yes, I did. Wait, just a minute. Don't turn around.
Okay. This is the dining room. And this piano. Mom, how old was you when Papa got you this?
I was 10.
Mom was 10. And how old are you now? Do you want to tell them?
I'm 61.
61? And then I'll show you the other living room. And her other tree. Look at it. She changes this doll on top, clothes, all the time. Here's your girl right here. Mm-hmm. And also here. You ain't got your village out, Mom.
No, I don't. Better.
With what, your village?
Mm-hmm.
But this room is very Mom. Hi, sis.
Hey.
Better.
Here's my niece. You all got to see her a little bit in the wedding vlog, but just for a second. Are you sad? She just found out that her teacher got a new job. And she's sad to be, for her teacher to be moving. I'm not really good at closing my eyes. Okay, I'm closing them.
Okay. Give her the bottom thing first. That's from them.
I love it.
I knew she would.
It's a Pride and Prejudice coloring book. Oh.
Have you ever seen one before?
No.
Me either. I didn't know that made such a thing.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I love you all.
Love
thank
you
so much.
Okay. There's one thing from each of them in here, and it doesn't
what's
matter.
What's this for?
Christmas.
Why am I opening it today?
One of them you have to, if you want to get used to it.
Okay.
Open the little soft thing.
A little soft thing, okay?
That's it.
Oh, how cute! It's a camper ornament. That is adorable. I love it. That is so cute.
It's a mug. I can tell it's a mug.
It's a mug.
How cute!
Merry early Christmas.
That is adorable. Where did you find it? Really? I love it. I love these wax melts, guys. It's from Scentsy. It's in everything nice. So good.
Thank you, Mom. You're welcome. It just looks so much like you, but you had to have it early to use it.
I did. Guys, this is my nephew, Gunner. Can we show him my old bedroom? Your new room? Let's go show him. Guys, this is my old bedroom. This was actually my bed. But this is now Cassandra's room. And when Gunner was a little boy, I used to read Goodnight Moon to him all the time. And I had this framed for him. What, Goodnight Moon?
Kind of a mess in here.
So yes, I think you need some more toys.
I think so, too.
Here's her little tree.
Luckily, it's Christmas, so maybe she'll get some stuff to play with.
Mm-hmm. Here's me and my brother, Derek. No, no, how old were we here, Mom?
Beautiful babies.
How old were we?
Like 2 and 4.
Yeah. Derek is 2 years older than me.
20 months.
This is a 6-week shot.
And this is 6-week shot.
And that's a 6-week shot of Derek. Just together here. And this is Granny and Papa.
These two are good.
I was sick in this picture.
You were 4.
I was 4 there. Really good pictures. Here's me and Mom. There I am.
Mom with a scrap of makeup on.
Hi, Bootsy.
Say hi.
Hi, kitty.
He's such a big boy.
He's feeling you. Hi. Watch his little head.
Oh, what a good boy.
Mom, let's show him your makeup. Everybody is always really interested, and I get a lot of questions about what your favorite makeup is.
My makeup?
Mm-hmm. We got Mom the same mirror and vanity that I have. Like mother, like daughter.
There you go.
And where'd you get that?
It Cosmetics. You gave it to me.
Yes, I did. When they were up at my house last time, I went ahead and gave Mom this big, that's the mega size tube of the It Cosmetics CC cream, ain't it?
Yes.
And what mascara are you using right now?
Ta-da.
The Lash Princess.
Lash Princess.
It's good stuff, ain't it?
It says. I can't read it. Let me see. False Lash Effect.
Yes. And what's your favorite, like, lip products? What's your favorite lipsticks, your go-to?
I use whatever falls up on the top right now.
Elf Classy. Okay.
Classy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and she's got the
super pink
nail polish racks behind there, too. One rack.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite blushes and stuff, Mom? Do you use bronzer? Is that the Vitality Face Disc?
And Tarte.
Where'd you get that?
From you. And here's another It Vitality Disc, but it's the cream, and it's a little bit, it won't stay on as long as the powder.
What you can do is put the cream on first and set it with the powder.
Aha!
And it will last longer.
Now we know.
All right. We just picked up Liam. So hi, Liam.
Hi.
Show him that fancy Christmas sweater. Look at that. That's Pug. I love it.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to find me one of them. Reckon where Mom and Dad got it. Don't know.
Coles.
Oh, I love it. Liam is actually my first cousin, but he's more like a nephew.
Yeah.
Because what do you call me?
Annie.
That's right.
And what do you call me?
Nanny.
Oh, baby, I love ya. What are you playing?
Dancing Lady.
We're just waiting on Nanny to come out of the doctor's office. I found me a lip gloss at Rite Aid. This is Wet n Wild, and it is a limited edition. And it is in the shade Ring My Bell Bottoms. It's like pretty metallic, but you don't feel any glitter whatsoever in it. And it's like this kind of light champagne-y gold. Do y'all see it? I actually really love it. I want to go back and get the other ones now.
You can see them way down the road here.
Your Christmas lights.
Okay, you got to look at Marshall's too. They're so pretty.
Okay, this is our neighbors here.
And cousin.
And our cousins, yep.
Look how sweet.
They have a really pretty log home. It's gorgeous.
Look at their lights. Look at these candles and things. How beautiful.
Oh, yeah. I think I missed it. I don't think I've seen that. Okay. This is our next door neighbor. They are an older couple.
Look how beautiful.
She's kin to us too, right?
Yep, that's his mother.
And here is our house, Mom's house.
And you'll be glad to know for Christmas time, Cousin Eddie has parked that camper right in the driveway.
Oh, that's wonderful, Mom. Oh, yeah, getting a good shot of this.
Look at my lawn lights. See the little random lights here and there? See?
I do. Yeah, you look quite festive.
Aren't they beautiful?
Mom and Ronnie had a camper give to them. It looks so nice out here by the house.
Yep.
We are having peppermint chip ice cream. Is that what? Look how pretty the fireplace looks going. You want to come make candy with us, David?
You can say no thanks.
We're going to make us our candy out of pool noodles. And Mom brought us a couple more. So wish us luck. We're gonna see how it goes. And our first piece of candy is made. Look how cute, guys. I like this better than I like the peppermint candies, but it turned out super easy. And you just use any kind of striped paper, wrap your pool noodle piece, and then put your
gunner
wrap on there. So pretty.
And then just tape it down to snug it up.
It's not that good.
Huh? It is. That's all you gotta do. Because the cellophane's gonna cover.
Look, guys, how many pieces of candy we've made. We've made a lot. We have moved on to making some more peppermint candies. Mom is tracing my other one.
I'm trying.
She stapled her finger to the plate.
I did.
David, get over here and help us make candy.
It's okay, David. We're good.
Get over here and help us make candy.
You'll get hurt. I just stapled my fingers.
Just getting in, guys, from my mom's. Came and let the girls out and did all that stuff. And now I'm going to try to edit and upload. Cross your fingers and hope I get it done tonight. But it's probably going to be late by the time we get it done. It might even be in the morning. I'm sorry. But I want to try my best to go and edit and upload now. But after that, I'm going to get ready for bed and go to bed. So probably going to be a little bit of a late night here. But I'm really going to try to get my video and then go to bed. So good night, and I will see you in tomorrow's video.